Knowing the right set of moves can make a world of difference in your gameplay. That's no surprise, right? Techniques have always been a massive part of Fortnite, but that's why for this video, we'll be going over 9 amazing techniques used by Taysen, arguably the best player in the world. What's up, ProGuides fam? I'm Cody, and this is gonna be a wild one, so hit that sub button and let's get into it. So, technique number 1 is a slick combination of moves that's actually a really great way to safely box and put aggressive opponents in their place. To start it off, Taysen builds a 2x1, which is really important here. But once he sees his opponent whacking at his wall, he positions in this spot, aims to make a window edit, and using his blueprints, he quickly edits, cones, and resets. He then edits the right wall, cones the ground, and gets the wall to the left. You can see it blocked the shot, so Taysen edits and gets a wall in the back too. So that pretty much boxes your opponent and gives you a nice right-hand peek. Unfortunately, he missed this time, but he plays it right, resets his stuff, and expands to safety. 2 quick notes on this one. First, remember to aim at the top half of your window edit to place that cone. If you're aiming too low, it won't place and your opponent might escape. And second, if you can, approach from the right side just like Taysen did, since that gives you the right-hand peek and makes it safer to place those walls. Next up is a slight twist to the well-known cone floor piece control move. But all that's different if you approach from an angle your opponent is less likely to expect, which seems to be all too important in this age of Fortnite. So to start, you get the cone and floor over your opponent's head. When they see this, the typical reaction from your opponent is going to be to aim up at the cone and floor. So instead, you can drop down to the side, grab the wall, and open fire from here. Taysen in this clip takes the 50-50 and wins it, but you could always do a window edit or position on the left corner of the box to play it much safer. Now, this next move is an arguably better approach for taking walls that makes your opponent less aware of your position and also makes it less likely for you to get edited on. Really though, we're not looking at anything too special here. You attack your opponent's wall from above on the left side, replace the wall, cone inside, and start shooting. Taysen uses this wide open edit since the more usual edits have crummy views from this angle, so that's what we'd recommend using as well. And that's pretty much it. Now your opponent might edit on you, so if that happens, you can easily just floor for protection. Or if they go for a top right triangle edit, you can even aim way to the right and place a sideways ramp inside their box to block their shot. Though really, a floor is probably your best bet. But because of your ability to place quick cover, this is why this spot is so strong. Now you probably didn't notice, but in the clip we just showed you, Taysen actually placed a cone inside his opponent's box before he walled. And this is a trick he uses all the freaking time. In scenarios where opponents are less likely to be holding walls, like recently reset edits for example, he'll cone or ramp before walling to essentially snag both at once. This makes his job way easier after he opens the edit, but you've gotta be quick and you gotta make sure that they aren't turbo building. You might be able to get both with turbo builds, but you probably won't need like sub 20 ping for that to even happen. But if ping isn't your issue, come on over to ProGuides.com. We've got coaches online 24/7 to help you improve at Fortnite fast. Now with 20% off using code RANKUP2021. Alright, so moving on, in this clip, Taysen's kind of in a rough spot after a fight when he gets pushed by another player. Ah, that's the arena I love. But after losing control, he expands out, which is a fantastic choice. You've always wanted to expand one or two boxes at the very least in these defensive situations. But why is this? Well, arena players can be kind of dumb, so if you can bait them into your builds, you'll have control over the fight. And that is exactly what happens here. Taysen sets up a box on the right, and this guy runs right in. They only have a couple of brick walls to work with, so Taysen goes to secure them, but look at how he does it. He takes the long angle and uses his AR, then a blueprint edit, another blueprint edit, and this guy is left with nowhere to run. An easy turnaround for Taysen, and it just goes to show you how important having extra builds to work with is. Okay, we all hate the situation when someone is attacking just non-stop from above trying to get into our box. This is my box, bro, get out of it! Those players are annoying to deal with, but here's a trick Taysen uses. He first sets up a 2x1, and then as soon as his opponent is about to break in, he places a backwards ramp, lets them in, and then quickly replaces the floor. This completely traps their opponent, so from here, Tayson backs up to his second box, then it's a simple Mongrel Classic to finish the kill. You won't always get the first kill shot, so that's why it's really important to have a second box you can back up into. Don't forget to do that. It is an extremely crucial step to this move. Next up is a really clever yet kind of silly play that can result in kills with very little effort. So again, Tayson starts with a 2x1 box, and he places a backwards ramp inside one of them. This guy starts trying to break in, but Tayson's gonna let them because his ramp essentially cuts that box in half. So they're gonna be forced to step onto the close half of the floor. And when they do, Tayson edits and says bye-bye as the dude plummets to the ground. To reiterate, this play is kind of a meme, but we've seen it used successfully surprisingly often. So it's not all jokes, and it can really get you some free kills as long as you set up and pull it off smoothly by timing your floor edit correctly. Technique numero ocho is something you're gonna use when you've got an opponent above you, and it's gonna allow you to surprise them with big damage plus the potential to box them in. Let's see how Tayson sets it up though. In this fight, he is expanding, trying to evade his opponent when he edits to cone them. The enemy ends up on top of Tayson's cone, but that works out because when your opponent is on your cone like this, that's when you can bust out this move. So he goes for a little side jump into a shot, wall, and floor, that exact order. And to place the floor, gotta make sure to look down. From there though, Tayson instantly window edits and puts a cone up top. But at the same time, he's making sure not to expose himself for too long. So he hits another shot, resets, then does a wide edit to put walls in the back and finishes the kill. This move seems somewhat simple, but if your timing is off, it actually is really frequent for your gun to not shoot or for you to mess up catching yourself. So you really have to practice the right order. Shoot, wall, floor. You can do this in creative, go ramp cone, and practice side jump, pretending there's an enemy you're shooting at just so you can get the timing down and do this consistently. Guys, this is a quote that my track coach used to tell me. Practice doesn't make perfect. Perfect practice makes perfect. So that means you can't just go out there and not give it your all when you're practicing. You know, even when you're still in this trial mode, you're practicing, just messing around, take it seriously, okay? Perfect practice makes perfect. Thank you, Coach Levine. Pro guys, we'll never forget you. Now for the very last technique. We've got a really interesting way you can turn a lost ramp rush battle into boxing your opponent like a flopper. So Tayson pushes this place here, and as soon as he gets ramped over, he immediately places a wall to block their path. Now, at this point, your opponent is either gonna expand out to the side, or more commonly, they're gonna jump up another layer. To take advantage, Tayson expands to the side, grabbing all the cones and walls, then immediately cones their ramp. He also grabs the wall, makes a safe edit from behind cover, gets the back walls, and then utterly destroys this guy with some straightforward jump peeks. Tayson's an incredibly talented player that performs insanely well. It is no wonder that people call him the best. He's so knowledgeable about the game, so go follow his channel if you don't already. But hey, if you found this video helpful and want to see more like it, leave a like and subscribe. We are so close to 1 million subs, and I know Keith Allen has been working hard on his Story of video, so make sure to share this channel with all your friends. That's it for this video though. Once again, I'm your host Cody. Have a good one, and I'll catch you soon, players. Cha, brah. Ciao, bro.